Suddenly, the kittens at Nay's feet started hissing. Just then, a huge lump resting in the tunnel got up and started moving. It was a giant rat. Dinner time, kitties. Hold on, I want to look at it. The animal's golden eyes probed the darkness like a searchlight. Its two protruded front teeth twitch as its large gray body moves agilely towards its prey. Okay, well, I'm going to use the animal claw on it. Her metallic claws gleaming, Nay daringly sprang at her opponent. Mm. 14 points of damage. And only 7. Sweet. That's a good hit. 20 points. It's, I rolled exactly 7 again. 2 threes and a 1. Interesting. Ta-da! The rat writhed in pain as its breathing failed. Its corpse finally fell into the water and became motionless. That's except for floating in the water. Another right angle turn leads south and east. What, where do we come from? Do we come from east or south? Dead end. Another dead end tunnel. A faint glow seeps out of a gaping hole in the wall. The hole is large enough for the kittens to get through, but Nay cannot possibly fit inside. Can I make it bigger? Yep, I knew that wouldn't work. Use a plank. How are they using the jerky would do anything? I can't even tell the kittens to get in there, right? I can't even look at the kittens anymore? I'll find a way around, I guess. I know I'm going back. How do I get the kittens to go through? Do I put the jerky in the hole? No! I don't want to use that. I don't want to use it. Not myself. Alright, well, stand by, guys. I gotta figure out what the hell to do. Okay. Her feline friends extended her an invitation, but she couldn't think of a way to pass through. As she was fretting, the kitten suddenly faced behind her and started making howling noises. How did I know I had to look at the hole again? Was that three times now? Curious, Nay turned around, only to see that the giant rat she thought she had defeated earlier was charging straight for her. Ah! Nay immediately jumped out of the way. With a bellow, the giant rat crashed into the side of the tunnel, subsequently getting crushed as the wall crumbled. This time it was dead for real. Yeah, I really believe you. I want to look at the area. I want to look at the hole. The wall now has a much larger hole in it. Even Nay can fit through now. A gaping hole in the wall. Bottom of the well. Light streaming down from overhead illuminates a bucket being suspended in midair by a rope. The ground underfoot turns to sludge here, and plants resembling ivies cover the walls. A circular slice of sky is visible up above. This must be the bottom of a deep well. Nay could grab onto the bucket if she were able to jump, but the ground is covered with muck and she would only slip and fall if she tried. The strong roots do not break when pulled, and the stalks are thick enough to act as footholds. The kittens agilely climb up the plants. How do I climb it? Look at it again? What does this mean? She's on it now? Does she pull it? Nay tried scratching it with her claws. Scree! What am I supposed to do? Plank? Take the bucket? No. I don't know, guys. Doing things like that is pointless. Of course it is. I don't know what to do. Attach the plank to the claw? Attach the claw to the plank? Alright, stand by again. I'm gonna actually look up a walkthrough for this because I don't know what to do in this part. And, this game is actually frustrating me at this point. Wait. Well, I can actually. Okay. actually move. I didn't realize that. Before Nay's eyes stands an ominous mansion. One of the rear windows is open to the south. Grass is growing rampantly around an old well. This must be the backyard of the elderly scientist's house. Voices of people engaged in a quarrel can be heard inside, along with sounds of violence. That's not good. Of course, with the violence, I'm gonna look back at the well. Connects to an underground network of tunnels. Apparently the kittens were passing through here on their way to play. Although she made it up here safely, Nay is too afraid to climb back down. That's fine. As we're looking through the window now. Nay surreptitiously peered into the window. She beheld a familiar room, but it was not in the same condition during her last visit. The interior was in disarray, and collapsed in the center lay the old man covered in blood. Beside him stood the hunter. Why'd the hunter attack him? That's no good. Hunting old man. Not very sporting. He's looking down at the elderly scientist with a nasty-looking bow gun slung over his shoulder. You mean making me hunt monsters and shit like crazy, you old fool. You know, the language in some of these games is funny. Well, I'm through being ordered around. Now, where's the money? The scar on his face twitched as he let out a cruel laugh. She knew that laugh. This was the same man who burned down her house half a year ago. The man who murdered her parents. The hunter presently disappeared behind the shadow of a bookcase. Hmm. Peeking through the window, Nay can see the old man lying on the floor, smeared with blood. The hunter seems to have left. South? Is that where the window is? Is the window south? Yeah. It's open. Yeah. The elderly man lies prostrate on the floor of his ruined laboratory. Smashed specimen bottles and pieces of glass from shattered windows litter the ground. A small safe in one of the corners has been ransacked. Nay might run into the hunter if she leaves to the main exit. She would be better off going out the window to the east instead. So that is a window to the east. But we went in through the north. Oh, we can't go anywhere right now, because we have to look at him. I wasn't gonna go anywhere, guys. I was just checking because we came in from the south. He is dying. Oh no. Oh, aren't you that girl from before? It hasn't been all that long, yet you've gotten bigger. He was astonished at her rapid development. Okay, all this while he's dying in this casual conversation. Of course. It's you. You're Nay, right? I've been trying to find you for so long. I should have realized it sooner. My research predicted your accelerated growth exactly, but I just didn't believe it. He removed a small bottle from the pocket of his lab coat with trembling hands. He's holding out a bottle in his quivering hand. Nay took the small bottle. That bottle holds medicine developed by your foster parents and myself at the culmination of our extensive biomonster research. They were both scientists and my colleagues. At the time, we were experimenting with the genetic synthesis of humans and biomonsters. The experiment failed due to an accident with the biosystem. Yet, in spite of that, a biomonster possessing human intelligence was formed. Yes, it was you. But I, considering you to be a flawed product, attempted to kill you. So they fled from the laboratory, taking you with them. I suppose they must have felt pity for one born an anomaly. Yet I couldn't let them get away with it. He momentarily stopped speaking to painfully catch his breath. I should have just let it go. Instead, I hired an outlaw to hunt you down. That was a mistake. That cruel man murdered your parents, and now, me. Nay, you can sell the contents of that bottle for a high price. I'm sorry, my recompense is so inadequate. With that, his breathing ceased. He is dead, the poor scientist. This bottle contains a white powder, which is supposedly the result of their research. Okay, well, there's a clone lab that might buy it. I don't think the weapon shop is going to buy it. And the hunter likes to hang out there anyway, so... Heading south, the path between the dwelling and the hedge is wide enough for one person. Some herbs are growing beside the wall. It's catnip. Handling it is making Nay feel euphoric. Sorry, guys. Mansion exterior. A slender path separates the hedge from the exterior of the house, ending at the outer wall. The broken limb suggests that someone has been through here. It is possible to reach the road on the other side from this spot. Okay, so we're in the residential district. Sign our way to the clone labs. We'll find it somewhere down south-ish. This is the gate. That's a little more west than that, then. Okay, more west. The building's interior is enveloped by an ominous atmosphere. I don't know if it's said this before, I'm just reading it. In the center of the room, a thin man stands beside a pedestal attached to strange devices. Upon spying the bottle Nate was carrying, the man gasped and his eyes grew wide. Okay, hopefully I'm at the right place. Is that the medicine I've been begging the old man to give me for ages? You must give it to me. I don't mean for free. I'll compensate you. Without waiting for a response, he snatched the bottle and pressed 500 meseta into her hands. Oh, you're back. So how about it? Have you changed your mind about participating in my research? He asked with an eerie grin. So what am I going to do with 520 meseta? Buy a better weapon? Hold on. Maybe I should go to the weapon shop. Say, that claw is really getting worn out. It could break at any time, he said with a frown. Could it? Ah, it looks like you've got the money. Let me see that claw. 300 meseta should cover it. Okay, we just automatically did that. Nay handed over her weapon. There, now it should be even stronger than before. I'm very pleased with it. And they received the extra sharp animal claw. Okay. So no change in the description here. I hope that claw serves you well, the man said with a smile. Oh, he's a nice guy then. Anything else to be seen around here? Now I'm gonna change... Oh, what'd I do? I'm unfamiliar with the keys in this. Alright, I'm gonna play all that over and I'll be back. Okay. What I was trying to do when I pressed that, I hit F8, I believe. I was trying to change the slot. I was trying to save into a different slot because I didn't know if I needed the jerky to continue or not. But I also wanted to save my game, just, you know, to save it because it's been a while. But unfortunately, I just reloaded my old game. But what I did is I did everything over and I still have the jerky. So that's what I wanted to, you know, I wanted to have that. I'm not sure what we're supposed to do with the pastry, actually. So, what do we do now? Yeah, stand by, guys, because they're going to be wandering around a lot, so hold on. Okay, we're supposed to go back to the field, which I would have no way of knowing. No, that's not it. That's not the way. That's not it either. That's to the east. And south-ish. An empty field outside of town. A bonfire burns in the center, and beside it is that hunter again. Well, I assume we're supposed to go here and fight him now. The man looked over his shoulder and grinned broadly when he spotted her. The scar on his face convulsed as he laughed, giving him a truly horrifying visage. So it's you again. I don't have any business with your kind now. With the old man dead, there's no profit in it. But that's fine. You're an eyesore anyway. He readied his gun. A nice guy. With his monster hunting gun ready to fire and his face dominated by a wide grin, he appears to be relishing this hunt. Alright, so I guess we're just gonna fight him now. Now we have that jerky, so hopefully it doesn't hit us for more than 20 points, actually. Oh my god. Okay. Use the jerky. Sweet. Her vitality returned! Well, he hits really hard. 9, okay, that's not bad. What happens when I use the herb, right? Does that do something? Does that restore also? I'll wait till I'm, like, down. Like, down in hit points. Have a low amount of hit points. That wasn't a very good hit. Oh. Okay, one more time. Well, that's a good roll. Sweet. The hunter groaned in pain as he collapsed. Nay fell to her knees. She had been severely injured in the battle, and her vitality was drained. Just then, look out! Someone shouted, coincident with the report of a firearm. Before she realized what had happened, Nay found herself forcefully knocked out of the way. Damn, missed. Said the hunter, his voice cracking. He still had some strength left in him, but a man stood in his way, sword in hand. Leave the rest to me. You're going back to my place. He spoke to Nay with authority. Okay. She remembered his face. He was the young man who had treated her with kindness earlier. Out of a sense of relief, or perhaps simple exhaustion, Nay faded into unconsciousness. It looks like you're awake. Feeling better? Nay opened her eyes to discover a smiling face she recognized had been watching over her. Okay. The young man is reclining on a sofa in a room that exudes calmness and order. You sure picked the wrong guy for an enemy. He's a wanted bounty hunter. A skilled one. Don't worry, though. I already handed him over to the authorities. More importantly, I have a request to make of you. Nay cocked her head in curiosity. What is this herb? Use herb. What if I do this? Nay sniffed the catnip. She began to feel faint. She experienced strange sensations. Nay returned to her senses with a pounding headache. These aren't ideal circumstances for this sort of thing. Okay. Let's look at the man again. You're a clever and courageous fighter. And pretty cute, too. Aw. If you don't have anywhere to go, why not stay here a while? As my little sister, since I have no family and am all alone. But she's cute. With his warm gaze enveloping her, she looked him straight in the eye and nodded slightly. Okay, this must be Eusis, also known as Rolf in the US version of Phantasy Star 2. Great, my name's Eusis. I work as an agent of the Matavian government. And you are? Nay. Nay? That's a funny name, but I like it, he said with a smile. Okay, look at Nay. I can't even look at the man anymore, I can look at Nay. Aww, that's the way she appears in the game. Nay stared at her hands and feet. She felt that both her mind and body had grown greatly in such a short time. It was as if her suppressed consciousness began to emerge when she was treated like a human being by Eusis. Thank you, Eusis. For the first time since that incident of half a year ago, she could believe in other people. Nay had regained a trusting heart. Thanks to the warmth of Eusis' love and the peacefulness of her new existence, Nay would go on to mature into a beautiful young lady. Never again would she have to try to fall asleep, terrified, within the shadows cast by boulders. Never again would she have to wander the wasteland aimlessly, tears filling her eyes. Though she might depart for distant lands, she would always have a home to return to. Nay believed it with all her heart. I'm not alone anymore. Eusis, no matter what happens, I will always be by your side. It was a mere 7 months before Eusis would embark on the journey that shook the world. The end. Written by somebody. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm glad this is over. Wow, that was one of the tougher adventures. It's really obscure stuff that you have to do and you have to wander all over the place. And I liked the other adventures. Oh, excuse me. I liked the other adventures a lot more, unfortunately. Although I do love this character probably the most out of any of them. But, hey, what can you do? It was enjoyable nonetheless. Thanks for watching. See you in the next adventure, which will be Rutgers, also known as Rudo in the US Phantasy Star release. So yeah, Rutgers Adventure. Thanks for watching, and this is Note Pudding.